What's up, guys? Today I'm gonna do something a little different. I'm gonna leave a commentary over my gameplay so that I can help you guys out for your solo hell diving. Let's start with the play style. I think is the most important for having successful solo hell dives. I think the most important aspect is probably knowing how to pick your fight, not just like going in guns blazing and just shooting at everything that moves. For this gameplay I am using the railgun because it's really good. I've been tinkering a lot with the anti-materiel rifle. I found it really really good, but it kind of like it's hard to use when you're under fire. Because you get like your aim just goes all over the place, so it's hard to hit those weak spot on the heavier guys. For stratagem, I am using a smoke stratagem. That is a very underrated stratagem. You can like destroy an outpost and then just literally just pop a smoke, go inside the smoke and then run away and then stop chasing you, so you don't have to worry about them coming to get you. I'm using also the 500 kg bomb. That's a great, you know, bomb for taking out heavies and also getting rid of those outposts and objectives. For the armor, we are using the light armor. Usually it's because right now the armors are bugged, so the armor rating doesn't affect much. And also we're using armor that uses the scout perk, which means that you are able to sneak around much more easily with it. It's quite powerful perk actually. You can stand right next to a patrol, like maybe like 2-3, maybe not 2-3 meters, more like 4-5, and they won't find you if you stay still and all that. You have cover, which is very nice. For the weapon, you can run the meta, you know, breaker and all this, but I found that the slugger and the plasma gun are really good. The plasma gun especially interesting against bots, very good against bots, especially those walker type enemies, because the explosive damage kind of bypasses the armor and it makes quick work also of those devastators and you know, those bit medium unit, which is very nice. The slugger is very nice too because it stuns those units, and pretty much you can one shot also with a good well placed headshot. What else? Secondary, I mean, there's only one good secondary, that's the Redeemer. Maybe it is the Redeemer, I forgot. The SMG one. That thing shreds. It's horrible with ammo, but it shreds like. It shreds a lot of units, which is very nice. When I use the breaker, however, I do use the revolver. The revolver is very nice to like snipe a little bit. I wish the iron sight for it was a bit better, but yeah, that's about it. So yeah, this game rewards you a lot solo if you pick your fight. I think that's the most important, and especially when you pug, it's kind of noticeable. When you run a random group with random people, they just go around just shooting at everything, or they have like a guard dog rover that shoots at everything for them. It kind of become pretty hectic really fast. Alright, I will leave you guys with the rest of the video, which was a very successful mission where I did not die, which was also very nice. So, enjoy!
Dropping a pin. West.
Sending down equipment package.
Objective located. West.
Thank you.
Tagging map. Southwest. Fabricator, northeast, 50 meters.
Thank you.
spotted. Throwing grenade. Dropping a pin. East. Found something. Tagging location. North.
Tactical asset within threat range.
Bomb arm! Clear the area! Dropping a pin. North.
Sub-objective in your vicinity.
Dropping a pin. Northwest.
Position.
Dropping a pin. East. Bot fabricator. East. Close.
Launching smoke screen. You may proceed to extraction when ready.
Dropping a pin. North. Shuttle inbound.
cooldown is 3 minutes. Launching smoke screen. ETA, T-minus 2 minutes and 30 seconds. T-minus 10 seconds. Deploying smoke screen.